Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to trigger things when you not only mouse over an object inside of Storyline, but when you mouse out. In a lot of ways in the past, when I've tried to do something, okay, I want something to happen when you hover over it, but I want it to return its value when you mouse out of it, was a challenge. And until like a recent update, I'm not sure when it was, but there's some now new options that allow you to return things once you actually hover off of an object. And it depends on what you're using. So we're gonna dive into that. So let's go ahead and go into Storyline. And what we're going to do is just add a simple variable. This is going to be hover over. And initially, let's just do a true or false variable. So when it's over and I hover over it, I want it to be true. When I hover out of it, it's gonna change it back to false. So let's go ahead and click OK. Now this one does not have some initial options, so it was a little bit tricky for me to figure out here. But if you go in and you add a shape, for example, I want it to be true when you hover over it, but I want it to be false when you hover out of it. Let's go ahead and see what the variable is. And usually when I'm troubleshooting or when I'm testing things out, I like to just add the variable value there. So I go into insert and go into reference and I can click OK. Now I can see what it is. Now, if you come in here and you initially just want it to change the variable, so adjust the variable, we want it to be true when you hover over that object. And so right here, hover over is the name of the variable. We're gonna change it to true when you hover over that object. There's no other option to say, okay, what if it's not over the object? Then what do I do here? Because the problem is if I preview this now, it's gonna change to true when I hover over it. So now if I go ahead and hover over it, let me restart that. Actually, I think I don't have it when the hovers over the text box. We need to have it hover over the rectangle. Now let's change that just to make sure it's happening on the rectangle. Okay, so there we go. It's false, but when I hover over it, it's set to true. But when I move my mouse out, it just stays set to true. So how do I change that? Well, instead of set, what we could do is actually toggle. So when it hovers over the rectangle, it's going to toggle it to true. So just by doing that, it now toggles it back to false when I hover out of it. So if I come into here and I hover over it, you'll notice that it's true. But when I hover out of it, it's set back to false. Over, true, out, false. What can we do with that? It's pretty simple. We are like, Jeff, okay, where's the application? Well, the application is now we can set things, other things like variables and layers and other things to show based on if it's hovered over. And you can even do this just on hover, but just to show you kind of the concept is you can come in here and let's just add a layer and say hover. And then basically we can come in here and say, let's add our text box, or we can have animations when you hover over it. But let's go ahead and just add a text box. Layer is shown. And we're going to do this in a couple different ways. We're gonna come in here and just add on a trigger that says, when the variable adjust, and what variable are we talking about? Well, that's gonna be hover over. Well, actually, no, not adjust the variable. We're actually going to show the layer. We're gonna show the layer hover when it hovers over, and we're gonna actually do rectangle, and I'm gonna come back to what you're seeing right now, but we're gonna do this based on the variable changes, and the variable changes hover if hover is actually set to true. So just by doing that, now we're able to show it. Now, if it's not set to true, we're gonna go ahead and hide the layer. So we're gonna select the else of hide this layer if it's not set to true. Just by doing that, we can now trigger other things based on the variable. And you can see now when I hover over it, the layer is shown. When I hover out of it, the layer is not shown. The reason why I'd wanna do this compared to just show the layer based on hover is because then I can trigger other things based on that variable. So that one variable change can now trigger five other things and so forth. So if you wanted to do it based on the variable, great. If not, you can actually do it, just show the layer based on the hover as well. And this is where the new option comes into play. So I'm gonna get rid of that, and I'm gonna actually get rid of this this toggle. And we're gonna just go ahead and get rid of this variable as well. So I'm gonna come into here and I'm going to show the layer and I'm going to show hover. Now this is where I'm gonna change it based on if you hover over that rectangle. This is the new option. This is where, or maybe I just didn't notice it. In my last video, I talked about how sometimes I just don't notice stuff, but this is the options that were released not too long ago, but you can see right here, hide layer when the user hovers out. So just selecting that option is now going to return back to its original state. It's going to hide the layer when I go out of that. And I'm going to go ahead. And I remember complaining about that on previous videos when I was trying to do stuff. So maybe Articulate did listen to that and updated that version. Because there's not a mouse out state. I can't trigger something when you mouse out of a thing. But this allows me to do something like that. So now, not even using the variable, I'm able to show the layer, hide the layer, show the layer, hide the layer, show the layer, hide the layer. And I could even do something like trigger an animation. So I hover over the object, trigger an animation to come in when it's hovered. And then when I go out, trigger the animation to go away. So there's things like that you can even do on a layer, for example. Let me come in here and let me add, like on the hover layer, let me add an animation that will come in. And I'm going to just do a simple square here. So this is going to animate in. And so let's have it, this is where it's going to animate in from. And I'm going to have this animate or fly in from the left. And it's going to do this as soon as the timeline starts here. But let's have this only show for like 3 seconds here. And when it hides the layer and it comes back to it, there is some settings inside of the layer settings. If you come down to this little gear icon, you could basically, when revisiting, automatically decide to reset to the initial state or have the save state. Save state would mean anything that it animated in will just automatically be there. We want to reset it to the initial state. So every time I hover over this, it's going to animate in. So let's go ahead and do set initial state, hit close, come back into our base layer. And because we have that trigger to show the layer, whenever you hover over the object, it should animate in that object. Now it's not going to animate out that object. That may be something where we have to show another layer that automatically has it and then animates it out. It could be complex, or you could just use GreenSock. Check out some of my previous videos on GreenSock as well. But just to show you this, I'm gonna hover over it. There you go, you can see it pop in. I hover out of it, it's gonna go away. Hover over it again, and you can see it animate in as well. So without using GreenSock, I'm able to, when I hover over things, have different things animate in. The challenge though is having it animate out. So that's basically what you need to do is just have the animation come in when you show the layer. Other triggers, if I show the layer or if I basically, let's come in here and adjust it to be like change state of, there is restore previous states. If you don't want it to be the hover state, you want it to be something else. Restore previous states to an object when you hover out of it as well. It's just that additional options that you now have available to you to take care or return things back to its original state before you hovered over it. Extremely helpful, extremely useful. I wanted to point that out there in case you needed it. If you want to check out more, you can head on over to my website. You can click on the blogs here. You can check out all previous blog posts. I cover everything, Storyline, JavaScript, XAPI, Camtasia, AI, and plenty more. You can check that out. If you're searching for something specific, you can come up to the top and search for something specific. If you want to check out my courses, the one that I'm currently working on right now is JavaScript Fundamentals and Articulate Storyline. Or if you want to check out the fundamentals of Storyline, XAPI as well, or Rise, you can check out those courses on my website. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow in this channel, allows me to reach more learning developers like you as well. My goal with this channel is to help you become the best learning developer that you can be, to go out of the box, to go beyond the box, basically, and customize e-learning in various different ways, whether it be Storyline or whatever tool that you're working with. So hopefully you get some value out of this, and I want to hear what else you want to actually see. So go ahead and comment down below and say, hey, Jeff, I want to see, I'm trying to do this or I'm trying to do that. You can always post, if you sign up with one of my courses, you can post that comment inside of my courses as well. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.